It has been 425 days since Trump admitted to sexual assault, and he is still in the Oval Office. Donald Trump was revealed 425 days ago to have made an admission on tape that he sexually assaulted women, and was proud of it. He remains in the office of the presidency, even as other powerful men in politics and business have lost their positions over similar allegations. There was a period of 14 days between the revelations of sexual misconduct by Representative John Conyers, DMI, and the announcement that he would resign. For Senator Al Franken, it was 21 days. Fox News founder Roger Ailes was ousted over harassment claims, as was network star Bill O'Reilly. Hollywood producer Harvey Weinstein was also pushed out after his many victims spoke up. Trump has yet to have his day of reckoning, in large part because of the support he continues to receive from the Republican Party. The Trump administration has alleged that every woman who accused Trump of sexual harassment or assault is lying. There are at least 16 women who have made credible allegations against him over the years. The recording of Trump bragging about forcing himself on women was released on October 7, 2016. Speaking to Access Hollywood host Billy Bush, Trump said, "You know, I am automatically attracted to beautiful. I just start kissing them. It is like a magnet. Just kiss. I don't even wait. And when you're a star, they let you do it. You can do anything. Grab 'em by the pussy. You can do anything." 2 days later, Trump acknowledged the recording's authenticity in a video statement. "I said it. I was wrong, and I apologize." Trump continued to receive support from the Republican Party, even from figures who had openly criticized the content of the Access Hollywood recording, including Mike Pence and Paul Ryan. Ryan even pledged that he was in total allegiance with Trump and his agenda. Now, Trump has reportedly started claiming that the tape was a fake, adding it to the collection of conspiracy theories and crackpot ideas he clings to and uses taxpayer dollars to pursue. "It isn't fake, and his confession was very real." Just as they have rallied around Trump, Republicans also stand behind Alabama Senate candidate Roy Moore, despite credible allegations of child molestation and inappropriate relationships with minors. While Democrats called for the resignation